Hello and welcome to day 18 of Breakup Recovery Series. If you're joining me live today, this is a Breakup Recovery Series for the month of August. Today is day 18. And today we're going to talk about dealing with loneliness after breakup. If you're curious about other videos in the series, you can check them out on IGTV. If you go to the story, to IGTV, you can check out prior videos. Yesterday we talked about how to find your identity after breakup. Well, today I wanted to share with you how to deal with loneliness after breakup. Oftentimes we find ourselves, especially if you spend long time, spend your life in a long-term relationship, you find out and you dedicated your life to your family, your kids, your spouse, and now you feel alone. You feel, how you call it? You don't know what to do with yourselves anymore. You feel depressed, you feel anxious, you're wondering how you should continue. And the way we grew up is we have this defined path. You know, when we are little kids, we find out this is what you do. You first go to school, then you go get a degree, then you start a family, and then you live your life happily ever after, and you have work that you dedicate your life to. And what happens when breakdown occurs? What happens when you have this terrible situation, this event that kind of breaks your life apart, breaks the normal, breaks the status quo? What happens then with you, and how do you kind of redirect your path and start going and, you know, being happy again? Because after all, don't you want to be happy with everything that's going on? So I want to share with you three things how you can deal with loneliness after breakup if you find yourself in that state. First of all, discover who you are. Oftentimes, a lot of people, what they do is they jump into a next relationship and they figure, oh, I just want to fill this hole. I had a, how you call it, I was living with this person, and now I want to just fill this hole, and I don't want to feel so empty anymore. And so we go out and we find that next relationship, and it's gonna feel good for a little while. But what you're doing in that sense, you're pushing away who you are, and you're kind of blocking your feelings, stamping down your emotions, and replacing. You feel like this other person that's gonna come is gonna fulfill everything that you were hoping for. But what happens is it doesn't last so long. Once that, as they call the honeymoon stage, is over, you're back again to your feelings, to your emotions. You're back again to feeling everything that you were feeling before. It didn't go anywhere, because guess what? No matter how far you go or where you escape to, you still take yourself with you. And you cannot run away from yourself. No matter what you say, no matter what you do, we need to process those emotions. And oftentimes what happens, if you don't want to find yourself in that situation, take time for yourself and discover who you are. What are some of the things that you like doing? What are some non-negotiables? What are some things that will break a deal? Do you know yourself truly? What happens is, if you've been in a long-term relationship, you lose your identity, and or you start associating yourself, I've been someone else's wife, I'm someone else's mom, but who are you as a person? What are some of the things you are great at? What are some of the things you don't like doing? And maybe you were complying just to be comfortable. So spend the time, discover who you are, take yourself out on a date, maybe do something great for yourself, first and foremost. And I know it may be difficult, especially, you know, you look all around you and everybody is happily together and you're by yourself and you don't know how to move forward. Be patient. Spend that time wisely and do things that bring you joy. Take yourself out on a date. Discover what it is you're all about. What makes you feel alive. Second thing, you define your new normal. Not society, not your family, not your friends. You get to decide what your life is going to be about, who you're going to be showing up as, who are going to be the people who you surround yourself with, how you spend your time. You get to define that. Don't take cues from society. Don't take cues from your family. Find out what it is that you need in your life, in your path, and go after that. And the third thing I want to mention is you decide to be happy, miserable, or sad. Because it takes the same amount of energy to pick any one of those. You get to decide every morning when you wake up. You set the intention for today. How do you want to show up? Who do you want to be? You get to decide if you want to be happy, sad, or miserable. You set the tone. And maybe in the beginning it can be difficult, but over the course of time, little by little, you can get there. You can rediscover who you are. You can do those three things. Discover who you are. Define the new normal, what it means to you. What does this new normal means to you? Because for me, I felt everywhere I looked, I saw families, happy families, complete mother and father and kids. And I looked at myself and said, something is wrong, must be wrong with me, because I was doing everything I thought I was supposed to. Yet, where did I end up? And I needed to redefine my new normal. I needed to find out what are the things that bring me joy, what are the things that bring me energy so that I feel fulfilled. And after breakup, you're trying to get to that new kind of new normal. What does it look like? You get to define that. You can find people who share similar interests or have same kind of background, and you know, get yourself together and surround yourself with people who have been on the path that you are going. And if you don't have people like that in your life, you can discover them by going pursuing hobbies that bring you joy, something you always wanted to do but you didn't get to because you were busy or the spouse didn't like what you were doing. But get this, you are important. You need to fill your cup first with energy, with things that make you feel alive. Because once you do that, once you practice the self-care and self-love that is so needed, then you show up as a better person, as a better mom, as a better employee, better boss, better overall to others. So take that time for yourself. Discover who you are and define the new normal. You are unique for a reason. You have a gift inside of you. And you need to find that gift and then share it with the world. If you found this message beneficial, feel free to share with a friend. If you know someone who is going through breakup and they feel that they are struggling, you can share my contact with them, and I'm here to help. I'm also, coaching is open and available, but it's on limited basis and it's transformational coaching. If you are looking to relieve yourself from anxiety, stress, overwhelm, feeling not good enough, you want to break through to that next level, then reach out, book a complimentary breakthrough discovery session and see if we can work together, see if we can break through and get you to that next level, the results that you're looking to achieve. And you can find out, there is a link in the bio if you're watching me on Instagram, and on other platforms I'll drop my link below. If you want to learn more, feel free to DM me. If you have any questions about breakup recovery, please put them below. Let me know which topics you would like to learn, what are you curious about, and how I can best support you. This recovery series I'm going to continue. I'm thinking of 30 days, so today was day 18, there are going to be more, so tune in tomorrow for more breakup recovery tips, tools and techniques. If you need this in your life, feel free to share with a friend. If you have a friend who is going through breakup or needs sound advice, I have been there, I know how you feel. So remember that you are limitless and the only person standing in the way of your success is you. So have an awesome rest of your Tuesday, and I will see you again tomorrow here live.